Okay, welcome to the CSIT edX Pars online forum session, edX Pars. So in this short video, I will discuss how to find experts and how to find CSS selector. So in a previous video, we started with a Google page, and we showed that how to find out the figure for expert of a hyperlink policy, for instance, here. So just we click over here, then we click on inspect. So once we click on inspect, you see on the right side, inspect is this code, HTML codes are highlighted, and on the left side here, you will see this web element is highlighted. Okay, so then now if I copy, and then copy, click on right click, and then copy, and then we go in. If we want to click on expert, copy expert, then we click on expert. Then we will open a Notepad Plus, and then let me paste it. So this is the expert of the web element privacy on Google page. Okay. So actually there is a checker formula. There is no single formula to find the expert. So for a single element, there can be multiple experts. Okay. Yep. This start with a tag name. For instance, this is the tag name. Here I already copied this outer expert. Its tag name is A. So then I can put it, even I can put A over here. So if I put stars, then it will be a wildcard. So then that means it will search for everything with ID FSR. So then when we get this expert like this way, and then when we click, we'll get this string ID within double quotation. We need to change it to double quotation into single quotation. Then I copy it again. And then when we find our expert from here, from source code, then we need to click on the console tab. You see the console tab? So this is same for you if you use Google Chrome or if you use Firefox. Yeah, there is no variation. So you gotta go to console page, and on the console, let me, okay, so in the console, you will type in $, then X, and within parentheses, and you will give a pair of double quotation, and within double quotation, within the double quotation, you will put the X button. So you see, then when you then you will press enter. Once you find one element over here, this, okay, then click over here, you will see the length is one, then you have got one. So let me, so if we want to go back to our source code, we will click on elements, right? So the second one is here. If you click on second one, you see it in the left here, the second and the hyperlinks here, that was terms selected. So in order to get terms, we need to copy expert, and then we will get the second element. Second element, everything is same, we will get the one with the second element. So if we come back to console, and if we press on up arrow key, then if we put 2 over here instead of 1, then we will get, actually this is the expert for terms. You see? So now let me try if I get this ID is for the parent of this. Parent is here. Actually, parent is somewhere up, actually span. This span, when you select the span, it selects the entire tree. These, and this. Span is for entire tree. This is an array. Okay, so then, let me see, if we want to select the entire span, maybe it's, okay. Okay. If we click on star over here instead of Okay, you see, if we select one star over here that Dr. Lutfara was talking about, if we, instead of giving an index, specific index, if we give star over here, that means it will select the entire all elements over here. So that means it will select everything under this pen, this ID. Okay, so this, it will select this, and then again we saw that this is so instead of for instance this one, maybe let me try with E by giving a concrete tag name. What happens? Because okay, sorry, it did not come because all of the things in the three elements of the array were not identical. Because the last one, you see the last one, it was showing only span. The last one, it was showing another span. Maybe the last one has another span. Let me see. The last one, this has another span. So this is why it is showing, this is this one. In the settings, this has another span. But for the first one, this one, it has A. And second one, this has A tag. But this has, yes, a different tag span. And we say, this is a span, if I have a span. Yes, go ahead, please.
What if you put span instead of A? I think it's the, span is the parent of all the element.
Yes, this span is the, okay.
In the console, you put the A on the tag name. If you put a span, I think
instead of A span, right? This one here, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So then if you put instead of A, if we put span, good notation. Then we will see get all three. We will set all three, right? Because this span was, this is what, because span is the parent, right? Yes, because this span is the parent of all this one, and also this one. There is another span. Okay, so in order to automation, while doing automation, actually you will learn this by yourself, day by day while watching. But now I want to show you how to find out next thing. So copy selector. In a later video, I will show you how to create this like this.
Sorry,
differently.
Mukhtar bhai, I have a small question.
Yes.
Actually, I just saw that under the span, you have another span. So is it possible to have a child name under the same span? Like span?
Yes, we can. For instance, if we do this one, this one, if we select the X part of this one, let us do copy.
Yeah.
Copy X part.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Then let us copy that one and see what we get. So it has, you see, it got a different ID.
Mm-hmm.
It got a different ID, and this is a span. So let me copy this one, and then put on the this on the. So when you click on this, you see that when you select this, right? It selects a larger area than settings. You see it has a larger area than setting. Actually, this is a span within this span. Okay, this tag is inside another tag. That means sometimes when you create a column and inside this column or inside and there is another cell. Like for instance, you have a larger cell, and inside the cell there is another cell. Maybe they created this way. Maybe in future they can put another something, some more items.
Yeah, I can see two span closing two span, right?
Yes.
Yeah, one is the parent span, and another one is the child span,
This is the child span.
Below that, there are two closing.
There is another span, but this span is for now, this pen is maybe unused. This pen is maybe unused. I don't see any use. Okay. So this pen is unused. Maybe they.
Yeah, I got it. Thank you.
So that's for the setting, I guess.
Yeah. This pen. I don't see why it is this one.
Oh.
For setting, but for this one.
For example, if you, in a paragraph you have 10 lines, you yeah. want to highlight two lines, one of them, then you can use two span from in the other span. So span uses in the HTML is the other purpose, not only like the child relationship, following the parent and child relationship. They use sometimes with the different purpose. For example, you can bold particular word, you can highlight it, some line, and you can make an italic format and so on. So using span to development is a totally different than the other purpose.
But it's yeah. okay, I understand now. Sorry, to interrupt, you can go ahead, bhai.
Okay, so then, we are lucky enough that in order to do automation, we don't need to know everything for the development purpose.
Yes, yes.
Okay, so like for instance, you can copy, you can select your expected item and then copy expert. Now let us do a copy selector. I am doing copy selector, okay, for this one. Which one I selected? Like for instance, this one privacy, right? So then I want to copy selector. So if I click on copy selector, then the same thing what I will get over here. Okay, so this one, the top one, or this one was the X path for privacy. Actually, this one is the X path for privacy. So it's for the CSS selector. So this is selector for privacy. The same thing. Actually, I earlier copied the same thing. Selector for privacy. Okay, so this one actually said it has only this one. I don't know. So let me
for the privacy.
Yeah, for the privacy. So let me go to the terms. For the terms, they will understand. Okay, for the terms, if we select this one, the terms, right? Yeah, these okay. are the terms. If we select copy and then copy selector, then I click on selector for, this one is the selector for terms. This is the child 2. Term is the child 2, and then actually, we know that child one, this is the child one or first element, and this is the second element. So in CSS selector, this is child two. So now let me copy this stuff and let us validate this. So if we go to console, then for CSS, we will type in dollar sign, and at this time, we will type in parentheses, no X is needed. For X path, we need X, okay? But for CSS, okay. we don't need X. Only this stuff, and within double quotation, we will put that, this one. So let us see, if I click enter, then it shows
it. It's in the privacy, should I say?
Yes, this is child one.
Okay.
Child one, child privacy. I copied to child one. So now if I, just I'm pasting up arrow, okay, it will show me, if I give 2 over here instead of 2, then it will show me the second side, right?
Right. That is terms.
This is terms, okay.
Okay. How about the setting?
Let me set in, if it comes with 3, we saw that it did not come up with 3 for array. I'm not sure, let me see. Okay, so it did not
come. Okay, professor. Professor,
yes.
Can you write last instead of number 3? Last,
yes. L-A-S-T. Yes, that should be a good thing. Instead of 3, last is here or?
I don't know. Try that one.
There is a last method. No, it will not come this way. Not this way. Maybe this way. This way, last is method, this way. Maybe it may come, no. Let me see if it comes as fast. So last first this was for X path. For instance, if I want to find X path for this one.
Okay.
For this one, what? X path, if I do first and then I do this one, then it will come to a first one. Okay, you said fast is not a valid X path expression. Why? This way. I need to do not slash, I need to give another parenthesis over here, and then I need to give this. Maybe this time it will work. No?
Sir, I think with the tag name, instead of A, you have to put span, I guess.
Start?
Yeah. Or and.
No.
Slash.
No, have some code. I will show you. Shall we have to check? Double check. It last work. No.
There is a parenthesis missing.
Somewhere we need to put either double quotation or forward slash or back slash, something this. Maybe this one would go here or somewhere. No. No, I'm not sure. Okay. I have to see my code, sorry. So that.
In the index, just put the last in the index instead of putting below.
Yeah.
No, the first time when you try to the first time, very fast.
Index should be in third bracket.
Yeah, here. Last.
That's the way you put index, right? Like in third bracket?
And last and, you should put the parenthesis because it is the method.
Yes. Yeah, I'm expecting it should come up, but it's not expecting. Coming up.
Third bracket, you the first quarter of the third quarter.
Index is first quarter.
Index.
There should be an index over here.
Put the index and let me show. And then put the last within the third bracket.
Within the third bracket?
Last should be in third bracket?
Of course.
Mukhtar bhai, can you give third bracket for last? Here, third bracket. And then the other way. Also, just before L. Before L. Yes. We are trying.
Once we figure out how to find X path by clicking right click, do copy and then by X path, most of the time we use this way.
Yeah.
And but there are some sophisticated case if that does not work, like partitions here. There is an example I saw here on
yesterday. Yeah.
There is an example.
I usually try to do it outer XML, HTML first, and then I did customized.
Customized XML. So yeah, finding XPath is sometimes difficult. So just in this video, that I want to give you a head start. How to figure out find that. So one. Tracing element, find element. Element in automation is the most critical and the most part, okay? You will get your framework ready. But once you work in a project, you will have a framework, right? You can reuse that framework in your next project, in another project. But what do you have to do? You have to just, you need to get your, set up your get path, over here, and then you have to do fine elements.
Yeah.
Fine elements, because these elements will vary from project to project, from one web page to another web page, right?
So line number 20, instead of A1, you can use the last.
Last?
Yeah, instead of one.
No.
Yeah.
Here, one?
Yeah, yeah.
Last,
and then, yeah. Let's see.
Let's see if it works. Dollar
X. First parenthesis.
Oh, I can only use this one. Okay, I have. Okay. Let us see. Okay. Okay, got it. Yes.
Yes.
Okay, got it. Okay, the last. Okay. The last I got is the fast.
Is there anything like fast by?
Yes.
Okay.
There's
Let's
fast,
see.
But there is no second. Why fast is not working? Okay. Last is working.
Maybe there is no fast, no? Sorry, I don't know actually. I'm just
no, yeah, fast as well.
Is there any fast? Okay. If I ask you fast. Yeah, you gave everything the same. Just you wrote fast instead of last.
We'll see in a later time.
Yeah.
Next time we'll
okay.
see.
Just Google it, then I will find.
Yes. Google knows everything. Yeah, this is the thing. Like, for instance, from APWA and from now and next, I like you. I like everybody to write your code yourself. Okay, so you please write your code and then. From our next class, so you please show us.